my Lyft driver dropped me off at Sears, and there's like nobody here. It's like I didn't leave Ohio.
Bye, Mom. Man, how did Beatrice know I needed a mint? Hang on, what you trying to say, Beatrice?
So the great thing about the Skyway in downtown Minneapolis is that you can basically get all the way across town without having to go outdoors. It spans a huge expanse, which is great because we were there in probably January or February. It was super cold, especially at nighttime with a wind chill on top of that. It was pretty brutal out there. The thing about it was, I didn't always have the easiest time finding my way, despite having some wayfinding signs. And as always, if you'd like to see some of the stuff I shot while on this trip, links in the description. We shot at US Bank Stadium, Target Center, Target Field, and the Allianz Field Preview Center.
I'm a little turned around. I was trying to find a little Indian restaurant that is on South 7th Street, but these skyways, as cool as they are, doesn't seem to be labeled based on what street you're paralleling. It seems to be more about what buildings it's taking you to. So, working on it. So, I'm still in the Skyway, but sometimes the Skyway just leads you right into a restaurant. So here's the sushi place. See, there's the Skyway I just came out of, and then just there's the entrance to the restaurant. This is actually really cool. I gotta figure out where 7th Street is. Now I'm kind of in a mall, by accident. I didn't realize it, but the entrance that I used to get back to the Skyway is the entrance to a theater.
I've always found it interesting what some hotels offer and others don't, especially given the price tag and how upscale they are. So I've been to some more upscale hotels in some more touristy cities like New York, Atlanta, Miami. And what was interesting to me is what places didn't have, despite them being a very nice place, didn't have a complimentary breakfast, didn't have a microwave in your room, didn't have a mini fridge in your room, and all that's fine. This isn't a complaint, I just find it interesting. And they'll even kind of taunt you by having a $5 or $10 water bottle on the counter that will get billed to your room if you open it. My way around that, of course, if you've watched my videos before, is I go to CVS around the corner and get a gallon jug of water for a dollar, and that will last me all week. Here at this hotel, however, in Minneapolis, they do have complimentary breakfast, and I do have a mini fridge in here, which is awesome. No microwave, but 2 out of 3 is not bad. Well, at least no microwave in the room. There is a microwave down in the lobby. I have a bunch of Indian food left, so I can put it in my fridge and keep it all week. I have enough for like another meal and a half in there. But in order to microwave it, I'm going to have to take my microwavable travel bowl, which I bring with me and we'll wash in the sink between uses in here, but take it down into the lobby and microwave my Indian food in the hotel lobby. So when the hotel lobby starts to smell like chicken curry,
day two.
And No, I have utensils.
I'm going to a convenience store to hopefully find water.
And now I have water. I didn't know that Minneapolis seems to be kind of a big city for music. And there's a theater on the block over there called like the Skyway Lounge or Skyway Bar or something like that. It seems to be like a rock and metal club. Like Killswitch Engage is playing there this Friday. Looks like Starset's gonna be there soon, which Starset was actually just in Cincinnati. And I've been seeing billboards for like, there's some kind of awards show going on at one of the venues here, I think next month, that's like hosted by DJ Khaled. And so that was going through my mind. I was thinking about, okay, well, when I get back to my hotel room, I'm gonna talk about this and you know, just kind of comment on it. As I was thinking about that, this guy walks past me. And you know how when you look at somebody and you just know they're famous? So this guy walks past me and he was a little older gentleman. He reminded me of kind of a Keith Richards type. But he had like a wide-brimmed hat on and like a purple scarf, and he's wearing like a black pea coat and black skinny jeans. And I'm looking at this guy going, this guy's in a band, this guy's famous. I didn't know who he was, I didn't recognize him. I looked him straight in the face. And then like I see him, and then I look to my right and realize that you know, I'm missing the elephant in the room, or the tour bus on the street, because on my right is this big tour bus with blacked out windows. There was no branding on it, nothing of the sort. But then the next guy that gets out is kind of clean cut, he's a younger guy, you know, also black pea coat, black skinny jeans with some of those boots. I'm like, that guy's definitely a guitar player, he's wearing those guitar player boots. So I don't know who this band was. They were obviously getting into a hotel, but they had just pulled up in their tour bus. So I just thought it was interesting. So I'm gonna have to keep Minneapolis in mind for the future, because it seems like quite a lot of music stuff is going on here, and I didn't even know.
We found out that the skyways go way further than we thought. We've gone through Target Center, and now we're getting into what seems like a mall.
My YouTube channel, it'll make a good, it'll make a good video.
There is a connection to the theater district, which I'll probably explore a little bit more later, because I've only seen it from the outside. We passed a bunch of Jack Link's stores, like the beef jerky brand, but they had like these storefronts on three or four places and some offices, so I don't know if they're headquartered here. I'll have to Google it.
And there's the Walgreens I walked to in the cold this morning, and I could have just come this way.
Been a pretty full couple of days. Obviously I have been filming my little travel vlog here because I've been filming for work, which is what I'm here to do. So yesterday we were at Target Field and Target Center. Today we were with the business team of Minnesota United FC Football Club Soccer. Interviewed their CEO. Went to their preview center, then you know, we drove over to the venue that is currently being built for them. We drove back to their preview center for another interview. Then we took a ride to US Bank Stadium, which is where the Super Bowl was played just a couple weeks ago. Got some exterior shots of that, and then walked the Skyway all the way back from that end of town, which is, I've walked a lot today. But I told myself I was gonna do one thing that was interesting, and that would make a cool travel video. Just because I was here, I should do it. So I'm gonna call a Lyft ride and go to the Mall of America. My Lyft driver dropped me off at Sears, and there's like nobody here. It's like I didn't leave Ohio.
Guys, I found the roller coaster. I found the rides. This is probably the most exciting. Look at this! Isn't it? Oh my goodness. This is huge. This is cavernous.
Guys, I'm so excited. really like giant robots. Like a lot.
He's always up there, watching.
So this giant robot, it weighs nearly 16,000 pounds. It took somewhere between 3 and 6 months for like 100 people to build, that's what they said. And there's like an estimated 2.8 million bricks in it.
So at this store, they make a 3D model of you.
So the Mall of America was neat. Of course, I didn't really go there to shop. I just wanted to see the roller coasters and how big it was, and you know, say that I'd been there. I did pick up a few things, and by and large, just kind of walked around and ate dinner. So I took Lyft to get there and to get back. And taking Lyft is really interesting. On my way back, it was sort of funny. The driver was a guy who was had a very thick accent. He was a native of Jamaica. And so we started talking, as I normally, you know, I'd like to strike up conversation with these people because they come, you know, you just typically generally friendly folks driving you back and forth to places. This guy was telling me he's originally from Jamaica, has lived in, I guess, San Diego for a while, and he was saying that he came here to take some of his courses for what he's doing in school. He came, I guess it must have been in the summer, and he visited, and apparently Minneapolis is really beautiful in the summer, and I can believe that, because at least the downtown area here is pretty nice. It's been super cold, but I would, he's like, it was green, everything was green, and my friend was telling me, oh, you should come here. And he said, you know, he got his apartment, and a couple of months in, he started noticing it was getting chilly, and he didn't know what to do about it. He had never experienced that before. Never had to turn a heater on in a house before. So he was saying that he's sitting at his house just with the blanket, not understanding what's wrong or like how to what to do about it. His friend literally had to explain to him, you need to turn the thermostat on when you're at home and then maybe turn it down a little bit when you leave. He told me about like waking up in the middle of the night when it was cold and it just kind of shocking him. He had this like a North Face kind of cardigan thing on, and he's like, this is my first coat. This is the thickest thing I've ever worn. He's like, my friend told me to go to Burlington Coat Factory, and I went there and they had me try on this coat. I don't understand, how am I supposed to walk in this thing? How am I supposed to drive? I can't move in it. So I got this thing because it was smaller. It was just a funny, interesting conversation. I know this anecdotal, but it was fun. It has been a long day. And I already explained everywhere else we've been up to this point, and then just walking around the Mall of America, which is huge. I'm so ready to sleep. I've got to get up at like 6:45 again tomorrow morning. Jared and I are going to do breakfast before appointments and check out. And then I'm flying home tomorrow night, and I should be touching down at the Cincinnati airport at about 11:30. And then I have a concert on Friday. I'm going to get some rest, guys. Day three. Okay, wait, sorry, day four.
So when you walk into this restaurant and you descend down the stairs down here, you walk under a chandelier made of hanging knives.
So that's cool.
Yes, I was like coffee.
So these are lemon ricotta hotcakes, and you can really taste the lemon in them. I don't know why this means lemon, but I'm gonna keep doing it.
Okay, so I'm at the Minneapolis airport. Just got through security. I'm so ready to go home. We had a great... We went inside US Bank Stadium today. And it's probably one of the most beautiful facilities I've ever been in. I'm dodging a lot of traffic right now, so can't really talk to you that much. But one of the hardest things in security, though, they have those drug-sniffing dogs. You're not allowed to pet the dogs. So they ran out of carry-on space on this flight. These chicken bag full of battery. My first flight got hung up on the tarmac for over an hour. I missed my connection, long story short. But thankfully, praise the Lord, I was on United coming back, but they transferred my ticket to an American flight that's leaving in 40 minutes. So I've got to make it over to this other gate. I'm going to make it home, which is good. My bags are still in Chicago, but thankfully I'm home. And also, thankfully, I had my laptop in my hands the whole time because I couldn't leave it in my carry-on, which I need for my concert, so I have that, and they're gonna deliver the bags tomorrow, so it's all good.